Managing Director Chennai and Head of Residential Services India. JLL has come out with two reports. One is the residential report, half yearly report, and the other one is the hotspots in Chennai residential market. We witnessed the sales has gone up in last 6 months' time, and for the first time in last 2 years, when the market has got stabilized, we're witnessing the sales outgrowing the demand, which is a perfect fit for the resi market in the future is concerned. The supply side has gone down, which is also a good proposition, because the supply has become more relevant. It has become more up to the market, and the developers are more cautious as far as the construction and the delivery of the projects are concerned. So, which is a welcome sign to the residential market is concerned. As far as the hotspots are concerned, we looked at three parameters, which is the real estate, which includes the quality of developer, the quality of projects in a micro market. We also looked at the connectivity, which is the second parameter, which we given weighted percentage of close to about 30%. We also looked at in terms of the quality of life, which includes access to healthcare, access to entertainment, access to convenience store, all small parameters which a day-to-day customer looked at was assessed, and based on that we came back with two important hotspots, which is emerging market in Chennai. One is your Pallavaram Thiraipakkam Road and Pallikaranai as a micro market. Another one is the Mount Poonamallee High Road in Guindy, and these are the two hotspots as far as the Chennai market is concerned. We believe with the stability coming back to the Indian real estate residential real estate market, with structural reforms in place, which includes RERA, GST and demonetization, we believe that the curve is looking more positive, the trajectory is looking more positive, and we are here to witness good days in residential real estate market. Thank you.
Having their back offices here, Citibank, Barclays, Standard Chartered, and all these banks which are here, a lot of automobile manufacturing which happens here, Hyundai, Ford, BMW, Renault, Nissan. Electronic manufacturing happens, Motorola, Flextronics, Foxconn. So the message which we'd like to convey is there is a lot of activity which is happening in Chennai, and it's not dependent on one specific sector. And we've also seen a lot of positive trends which are emerging. So if you look at the office market, there is a good steady demand. We have several pan-India developers who are developing projects, Brigade, RMZ, DLF, Rahejas, Tata's, Xander, Ozone, all of them, you know, coming up with large IT parks, which is, you know, driving the demand here. We've also seen these developers going and picking out their second and their third projects. So it's not only the one project which they have, but, you know, they are picking up their second and third project because their existing projects are 100% leased out. We had Asadas picking up land, and many other developers also in the process of picking up land, and the scenario is the same for residential also. We've seen a handful of active residential developers picking up land for their new projects. Moving on from a financing perspective, although we read about a lot of liquidity crunch, the good developers, they are still able to raise money in today's market. And last year we had a great project called SP InfoCity, which was held by Canadian Pension Fund, and this got sold to a Singapore-based fund called MapleTree. And the third segment, industrial, Chennai being a port city, we are seeing a lot of activity on the industrial space as well. Chennai market has a demand of about 4 million square feet. Here again, a lot of institutional players are very active. You have players like Indospace, ESR, Ascendas, Logos, Sumitomo, all these guys are, you know, very active on the industrial space as well, specific to Chennai. And Chennai being a port city, I mean, a lot of demand from e-commerce players, and GST also is creating demand. From a retail perspective, Chennai has about 5 large-scale mall, each about 500,000 square feet and more. And the good thing is, earlier Chennai had only one mall, now you have all these malls in different locations. So, you know, the demand for retail has also been spread. So apart from the regular malls, we also have, you know, we call the neighborhood mall, 200,000 square feet malls, which are mushrooming in different areas. So overall, a lot of positive trends is what we see in the market across different sectors. Focusing more on the residential segment, I would like to call upon
the H1 update. We will talk about what's happening on the residential market in India, and also we're also looking at the hotspots in Chennai, the top two hotspots in residential market in Chennai. Apologies for not giving the printed report for you. We were supposed to have Samantha Das, who's our head of research, to travel from Bombay to Chennai today. Unfortunately, today the flights are not flying, so that was the reason we were not able to provide you with the hard copies. Just to give a snapshot about what's happening around in residential real estate market, with all the structural reforms which is happening in the market, which includes RERA, which includes demonetization, GST, which happened in year 2016-17, we see a lot of they are more focused on delivery, they are more focused on construction activity, they are more focused in terms of creating more cash flows, their projects currently. And also the important part that we are seeing in the market is that developers are looking at more relevant projects. They are not simply looking at in terms of taking projects in different micro markets. And very interesting in terms of the current supply, the supply actually have come down in the year 2019 first half by close to about 11% has come down. As I said, the launches have been modest. Developers are very cautious, and interestingly, 58% of these launches have come in the mid or affordable segment, which is sub 75 lakhs across cities. Barring Mumbai and Hyderabad, almost all cities have seen launches coming down. Especially Chennai has a very sharp fall. Chennai has a fall of close to about 45 to 50%. One reason could be attributed is that we had the FSA norms changing in the year 2018 December, which has a very telling effect in terms of the launches are concerned. So developers are reworking, they are re-looking at those FSI. So that could be one of the reason in terms of launches coming down in the first half. In terms of the sales, we are witnessing the first time once the real estate market became stable. In fact, why I'm saying the market being stable is because 2016, because of demonetization, the supply had come down, and there were periods where the sales were above the supply. But once the market stabilized, this is the first time after 2016 we are seeing the sales outgrowing the supply. So that's a extremely good positive sign. We are seeing the market, the government is stable, the market is stable, and for the first time we are seeing the demand overtaking supply. Predominantly the mid and the affordable segment is actually driving the growth. And the small statistic from a Chennai perspective, we are down by close to about 7% vis-a-vis the H1 2018. But one of the reasons could be that the launches have come down in the year 2019 first half. That also could be the reason why the sales went down a bit, but more or less it's more stable, and we are getting to terrain which is more positive and more stable as far as the market is concerned. Again, as I said, the supply set have actually come down. It's a drastic drop of close to 51%, but this is primarily because of the fact that developers are getting more cautious in terms of the liquidity in the system. We are also concerned about the NBFC crisis, which is looming large. So liquidity is one of the important aspects why developers are more focusing on delivery, construction of the project, and that's one of the reasons why the supply has actually gone down. So the focus from the developer side has been on the mid and the affordable segment. The mid and the affordable segment is what we defined as anything which is above, below, which is actually catering to the current demand. It's predominantly driven by end users, and we see this trend in the supply side, which is close to about 80% of the supply coming at about 60 to 75% of the supply is below 75 lakhs as a ticket size.